Much. Let's bring back in our panel. Abby Phillip is with us, Patrick Healy, and Matt Lewis. All right, so Spicer is saying truly that because there were quotes used, Patrick Healy, that does not mean that we should take it literally. He had a long exchange with Peter Alexander of NBC about what we should take literally or not. Let's just show a tweet sans quote for a moment, because the president did not use quotation marks in this one. How low has President Obama gone to tap my phones during the very sacred election process? This is Nixon Watergate. Bad or sick guy. All right, so Spicer's explanation doesn't hold up there.
No, I don't see any air quotes in that tweet. I mean, he, you know, President Trump has been using Twitter for years to communicate. He thinks communicate quite effectively, quite directly to voters and Americans. He was not, as near as we can tell, sort of suggesting that this was an iffy proposition. He had a clear accusation to make about wiretapping, had a clear hit to make in calling President Obama a bad or sick guy. What he didn't have was any kind of evidence to back up the use of the word wiretapping. You have to wonder, God, you know, does President Trump sort of understand what the word wiretapping means, right? The implications of that. This is a dangerous path for the White House to go down. You see the press secretary using sort of air quotes, you know, at the podium. Do you want an air quote presidency where everything can be sloughed off by saying, well, you take him too literally, you take the president too literally? This is very dangerous politics to play. I know that the White House likes to sort of make the argument about sort of fake news and the failing New York Times and CNN and so forth, but how seriously can you take a presidency that just goes to kind of air quotes as an argument?
Well, look, don't discourage the attacking, because it's never done better for your subscription rate than right now. I mean, right. We see reaction formation to what the president says all the time. If he attacks something, Brother Lewis, often people then wind up cottoning to it. You see it in the Times subscriptions, you see it in CNN's ratings, but that doesn't mean it's good for America. We know what's going on here. They're trying to say, treat the wiretapping the way you are all these Russian connections. There's a fundamental difference, and that was the point of the conflict with Kellyanne. It wasn't personal. It wasn't about disqualifying the president. It was, you are a phone call away from answering this question. You can get the answer right away. You can declassify whatever information you get immediately. Nobody has more power to do that than the president. You're not doing it, and therefore this is not as genuine a pursuit as those other things, and it does play as a distraction. Is that just the truth?
Not just I think you're right. It's not just a distraction, though. I think there are long-term consequences that could come from having a president that says things that Americans aren't sure if he really means them or not. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, when you are the president of the United States, your words have consequences. That's why diplomacy matters so much. That's why you sweat the details. You worry about precision. Is this the right word? Have we vetted this information before we put it out? People can go to war, you know, over something that a president happens to just say, right? So I think that this is irresponsible. I mean, it's an obvious point. But when you say wiretap, when you say the president did something, you either mean he literally did it or he ordered it. Uh-huh. And so in a tweet that has 140 characters, they're now walking away from two different parts of that, you know, parts of their statement.
Look, and you know, we haven't heard Paul Ryan or really any other big name Republicans backing up the president's claim, evidence-free claim of wiretapping. This at the same time,
they're not shouting it down either, by the way.
They're
asking for evidence, though. They're asking for, you know, they've set these deadlines and asked for
Right, but even that's the middle road here, right? If this had been President Obama, if this were Hillary Clinton who put out something like this, they wouldn't be saying, let's wait and see the evidence. Sure. They'd be all over it.
So, Abby, I just wonder what you think the play is here for the White House on this. Because come Monday, I mean, the House Intel Committee has extended this deadline for the Department of Justice to provide any evidence, but the deadline's Monday, or they, you know, they can subpoena it, and they very well may, if there's anything there. And you've got, you know, Comey, who's going to testify, is going to be directly asked this question. So what's the play here for the White House?
The White House wants this to go away. They want people to just forget this. I mean, part of the strategy, not just with this, but with other issues, is to push things off, to cloud the public record so that it becomes less clear what was said. There are more questions asked and confusion abounds. At the end of the day, they're hoping that everyone is distracted by something else that comes up so that they're not always asking questions about this. The problem is that this is a really big deal. The current president of the United States United States accusing the former president of breaking the law is a really big deal, and it's maybe an even bigger deal than any of the other unsubstantiated allegations that the president has made since taking office. And so for that reason, I actually find it hard to believe that this one is going to just fall off the radar. I mean, the very fact that there are congressional investigations and the fact that the White House themselves put Congress in a position of needing to have an investigation is problematic for them. I mean, the best that they can hope for is that the Justice Department comes back and says, you know, here's what we have. They hand over a couple of sheets of paper, something fairly thin, and then, we have a discussion about that, and we move on, settling this as an issue where they provided